Let's do it. This is how UYCAZ. Hey, this is how UYCAZ. Hey, keeping the faith in the King, and the patience will give us those free.
What is love? God is love, right? I'm gonna show you what it means to love God. All right? Because as a nation, we haven't learned what it means to love God according to the Bible. We've learned how to love God according to men. And the Bible says, give me that hope, give me Jeremiah 17:5. Because when we learn how to do things according to men, that's when we become cursed as a people. We got to do everything according to what thus saith the Lord. Okay? So I'm going to give you this. Jeremiah 17:5.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 5. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man.
The Bible says, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. All right, a lot of our people, where's the heart? Give me 17:9.
17:9. The heart is deceitful.
The scriptures say the heart is deceitful. So what you think love is according to your own heart, you're deceived by your own heart. Because God's words are true, right? And I'm not talking specifically you, I'm talking in general. As a people, our hearts, we're deceived by our own hearts and our own minds. And when we trust in other men to identify what the Bible has already, what God has already told us, all right?
The heart is deceitful above all things.
Above all things. That means there is nothing else more deceitful than your own heart, all right? Ooh.
And desperately wicked.
So it looks for wickedness. Your heart is always trying to find something that is wicked. It always wants to do something it wants to do. Alright?
Who can know it?
Who can know it? Who can know it but the Most High God? He knows your heart. But the Most High said, you have to learn what his words are. Go back to his first John. So I asked you a question. Do you know what love is according to the Bible? And you said, no. Okay. That's what I'm here for. We're here to teach our people according to what God says. Because a lot of times we go by our heart. I know before I came into the truth, everything that I did was according to my own heart. I thought something was right, so I was going to do it. And that's how everybody, that's how...
That's what I do today.
Right. That's what we do today as a people. But the Bible is going to teach us what is going to make us love God.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God.
This is the love of God. So you said God is love, right? And that is biblical. But what does it mean when it says God is love? What does it mean when it says, what is love? Read that again.
For this is the love of God.
So this is the love of God. What is about to come out is what we're going to show you. This is the love of God, all right?
That we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous.
The love of God is when we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. Do you know your nationality, sis? Do you know who you are? Okay, that's a color. All right, we've all been taught that we're black. But are we really black? Is that beanie on your head? Is that black, or are you black? The beanie's black, right? But can you say, I can go back to the country black? Can you say there's a country called black that I can go back to? No, right? So that's an error when we say we're black. So if... It was a trick. All praises, all praises. That's a good thing. Do you know you're keeping a commandment right now? What commandment do you know you're keeping? Right now, according to the Bible, the woman is supposed to have their head covered when the scripture is coming out, which I see you have, right? All right? That's according to scripture. But do you know what also is according to scripture? That we wear fringes. That our men now wear dresses. That our women wear skirts and not pants. All right, give me that in Deuteronomy 22. All right? So I asked you a question before you get that. I asked you a question. Do you know what nationality you are? Okay, if you look on that sign, what does it say?
I'm not going to sit there and tell you the right story because I don't need to tell you the story of the lie.
That's, you know what? That is honorable, because most of our people think they know. Most of our people are wise in their own eyes. Right. So according to that sign, right, and this is according to the Bible, what are you? Okay. Okay, and that's what we're here for, because if the Bible says that we are supposed to have men that are supposed to teach, right, our people, right, how can man let someone learn without they have a teacher, all right? Give me Deuteronomy. According to the Bible, I'm sorry, according to the Bible, you are the tribe of Judah, of the nation of Israel, if your father is black. Is your father so-called African-American? So-called.
So-called.
So according to the Bible, you are of the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
All right, of the nation of Israel, God's chosen people, right. His holy nation, all right? This is a law, a heritage given to us as a people.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5. The woman.
So it's addressing the woman. It's not only going to address the woman, it's going to address the man.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Meaning, what does that mean? Exactly. Do you know pants? Do you know the history behind pants? No, not your history, but do you know the history behind pants? A male boomer, which was an Edomite, which is a red person, a white person, we know today. She pretty much put that out there that women could wear pants just like men. So to be equal with men, because what's that expression, that old expression? Who wears the what in the family, in the house? In the house, all right? So we've been taught, you know, if the woman wears the pants, you know, they could get the same kind of jobs as us. They could do the same thing as us. They can get paid just like us, right? It's all about trying to be equal with the man. But what does the Most High say? What does the Most High say about, yeah, 1 Corinthians? What does the Most High say about order in our house, in our households and in our nation? Because there is an order that we haven't been taught, right? We've been taught that women are equal to men. I'm going to show you that that's not biblical.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 3. Then I would have you know that the head of every man...
The head of every man, right? That's the man, all right? That's gender specific. The head of every man...
Is Christ.
Is Christ. Jesus Christ. That's the head of every man, right?
And the head of the woman...
And the head of the woman, that's you. The head of the woman is what?
Is the man.
That's biblical. The head of the woman, so it's man, or it's woman, man, Christ. And who's above Christ? Who's above Christ? Huh?
And the head of Christ!
And the head of Christ! Because we know it's woman, man, Christ.
Is God!
The head of Christ is the Most High God. Alright? So that's what we haven't been taught as a people. Everybody wants to be equal with us. But the Most High said, in the nation of Israel, we are to have structure and order. And the head of Christ is God.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.